It's nighttime in the big city. Foghorns bellow in the gloom along the wharf. A crying woman in a nightgown can't flag down a cab. It's Theme Time Radio Hour with your host, Bob Dylan.
Welcome once again to Theme Time Radio Hour. And tonight we're going to talk about a subject close to my heart, women's names. That which we call our nearest and dearest, the ones we love and want to love. Let me quote William Shakespeare to you. What's in a name? That which we call a rose, by any other name, would smell as sweet. So call your sweetie and tell her we're going to play her a song. We're not going to go in strict alphabetical order, but we're still going to start off with A. A is for Anna, and for Arthur Alexander. Arthur was a singer and a songwriter, part of the Muscle Shoals scene, hanging around with people like Dan Penn, Spooner Odom, Billy Sherrill, and Rick Hall. He didn't get a lot of traction, unfortunately, and ended up quitting the music business altogether, driving a social services bus to make a living. He made a comeback album in 1993, but didn't live long enough to enjoy the fruits of it. He passed away on tour supporting the record, but his songs live on.
Number 12, Bobby. Arthur, sell me real fine. You should get better each time, okay?
He's one of the few artists who have his songs recorded, both by the Beatles and the Rolling Stones. The Rolling Stones did his song You Better Move On, and the Beatles did this one, Anna, Arthur Alexander.
Anna, you come and ask me, girl, to set you. Girl, you say he loves you more than me. Well, I will set you free. Go with him. Go with him. But Anna, girl, before you go now, I want you to know now.
Was Arthur Alexander and Anna. Another version of the name Anna is Annabel Lee, as heard in this poem by Mr. Edgar Allan Poe. It was many and many a year ago in a kingdom by the sea that a maiden there lived whom you may know by the name of Annabel Lee. And this maiden she lived with no other thought than to love and be loved by me. She was a child and I was a child in this kingdom by the sea. But we loved with a love that was more than love, I and Annabel Lee. With a love that the winged seraphs of heaven coveted her and me, And this was the reason that long ago in this kingdom by the sea, a wind blew out of a cloud by night, chilling my Annabel Lee, so that her highborn kingsmen came and bore her away from me to shut her up in a sepulchre in this kingdom by the sea. The angels not half so happy in heaven when envying her and me. Oh, this is a long poem. That was the reason, as all men know, in this kingdom by the sea, that the wind came out of a cloud, chilling and killing my Annabel Lee. But our love, it was stronger by far than love of those that were older than we, of many far wiser than we, and neither the angels in heaven above nor the demons down under the sea can ever dissever my soul from the soul of thy beautiful Annabel Lee. For the moon never beams without bringing me dreams of the beautiful Annabel Lee, and the stars never rise but I see the bright eyes of the beautiful Annabel Lee. And so all the night tide I lie down by the side of my darling, my life and my bride. In her sepulchre there by the sea, in her tomb by the side of the sea. Edgar Allan Poe, Fender Bender poet. Let's hear one now from the poet laureate of Lubbock, Texas. Of course, I'm talking about Buddy Holly and his song about a sweet lady by the name of Peggy Sue. This song was originally called Cindy Lou, but the title was changed in honor of Jerry Allison's girlfriend and future wife. Jerry Allison paid Buddy back by playing some of the best paradiddles ever heard on a record. Here's Peggy Sue, Buddy Holly and the Crickets.
If you knew Peggy Sue, then you know why I feel blue without Peggy, my Peggy Sue. Oh, well, I love you, girlies, I love you, Peggy Sue. Peggy Sue, Peggy Sue, oh, how my heart yearns for you, oh, Peggy, my Peggy Sue. Yes, I love you, Peggy Sue. Peggy Sue, Peggy Sue. Pretty, 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 pretty Peggy Sue. Oh, oh, Peggy, my Peggy Sue. Oh, well, I love you, gal, and I need you, Peggy Sue.
I love you, Peggy Sue, with a love so rare. Oh, Peggy, my Peggy Sue. Well, I love you, gal, I want you, Peggy Sue.
I need you, Peggy Sue. I love you, Peggy Sue, with a love so rare and true. Oh, Peggy, my Peggy Sue. Oh, well, I love you, gal, and I want you, Peggy Sue. Oh, well, I love you, gal, and I want you.
If you knew Peggy Sue, then you'd know why I feel blue. Buddy Holly and the Crickets. Peg is from Meg, which is a diminutive from Margaret, which is from the Greek meaning pearl. I don't think the song would have sounded as good with the name Pearl. Sometimes a woman's name doesn't necessarily mean it's a woman, like in this song from 1970. Here's a story of an encounter between a naive young man and a person named Lola. Ray Davies says he was inspired to write the song after a friend of his spent the entire night dancing with a transvestite. He was too drunk to notice her stubble, and the rest is history. The Kinks. La 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 Lola.
I met her in a club down in Old Soho, where you drink champagne and it tastes just like Coca-Cola. C-O-L-A Cola. She walked up to me and she asked me to dance. I asked her her name and in a dark brown voice she said hello.
Lola. Well, I'm not dumb, but I can't understand why she walked like a woman and talked like a man. I bet she did. Ray Davies and the Kinks. L-O-L-A Lola. Here's some other songs with spelling in the title. B-A-B-Y by Carla Thomas. C-H-I-C-K-E-N by the McGee Brothers. R-O-C-K in the USA by John Mellencamp. D-I-V-O-R-C-E. By Tammy Wynette. And we can't forget G-L-O-R-I-A. If you don't know how to spell, that spells Gloria. Dave Barry once said, if you drop a guitar down a flight of stairs, it will play Gloria on its way to the bottom. Let's see if that's true. How about that? This is Theme Time Radio Hour, talking about women's names. Some of the names are common, and some of them are a tad unusual. Like this one, Sophonia B, by Calvin Bowles and his All-Stars. I myself don't know much about Calvin Bowes, but our good friend Billy Vera has the lowdown.
Calvin Bowes, real name B-O-A-Z, Boaz, was a trumpet-playing singer in the Louis Jordan mold, recorded for a couple little labels, and had one good-sized hit on Aladdin called Saffronia B.
If you're going to crank something up, crank this up.
Jack, you better take it slow, 'cause the chicks are raring to go. Well, you reach under the bed, grab a jug, take a little nip, get ready to mug. Look at your gal, you kiss her and you send her, make a holler,
I surrender, I surrender.
I'm smuggin', shoot the liquor to me, John boy. Take a tip from me, she's sweet as my saffronia bee.
Reaching under the bed and grabbing a jug, taking a little nip and getting ready to mug. I myself have never met a woman named Saffronia, but I wouldn't be adverse to it. The most popular woman's name in Chile is Maria. In Japan, it's Misaki. In Spain, it's Lucia. In Denmark, it's Emma. It's also Emma in Scotland and Norway and Sweden. Coming up next on Theme Time Radio Hour, 6'3", 300 pounds, the mighty Howlin' Wolf. He's accompanied here by one of the finest guitarists who ever played with him, the blazing incandescent Hubert Sumlin. If you don't believe me, just give a listen to this one, Louise.
No!
That was Harlan Wolf with Louise. When Hubert Sumlin was 10 years old, he snuck out to the local juke joint and stood on a pile of Coca-Cola crates to see Harlan Wolf play. A few years later, he started a band with James Cotton. When Harlan Wolf heard him in a West Memphis club, he brought Hubert to Chicago to join his band. And the records they made together were some of the most powerful to come out of the Chess record label. Harlan Wolf, Louise, a name of old German origin. Its meaning is renowned fighter. There are 36 variant forms of Louise. Among them, Eloise, Lois, Louisa, Luella, Louisiana, Lulu, Lola, Lolita. Help yourself.
Listen, didn't you have a daughter? Didn't you have a daughter with a lovely name? Yeah, a lovely, what was it now? A lovely lyrical, lilting name like,
Lolita.
Lolita, that's right. Lolita, diminutive of Dolores, the tears and the roses.
Maybe you know a few more. If you do, send us an email. We're talking about women's names on Theme Time Radio Hour. And next up are the Janettes. They got their name in an interesting way. Zell Sanders owned a label called J&S Records. In 1963, when she was recording this song, she took the J from J&S Records and the middle name Annetta of the singer Leslie Valentine and created the name the Janettes. They had a big hit with their version of Sally Go Round the Roses, a nursery rhyme turned pop hit about the pretty roses and how they won't tell your secrets, and neither will I. Janettes with Sally Go Round the Roses. There's all kinds of theories about what that song means. Some people say it's about a religious experience or a mental breakdown. Some say it's about a closeted lesbian. But some people think it's simply a song chanted by children as they're jumping rope. Jump rope rhymes are not always as innocent as they sound. like this one. Lindsay Borden took an axe, gave her mother 40 whacks. When she saw what she had done, gave her father 41. See what I mean? Sally, by the way, means princess or lady in Hebrew, because it's the pet form of Sarah, which is also the name of the wife of Abraham in the Old Testament. She became the mother of Isaac at the age of 90. As Oprah would say, you go, girl. Her name backwards is Harpo. Next up on Theme Time Radio Hour, in our cavalcade of women's names, is Karina Karina. It was originally recorded by Bo Chapman, who was a member of the Mississippi Sheiks. The song had great popularity and was covered by a great number of people, including the two bad boys, Ashley and Abernathy, and these guys. Bob Wills and the Texas Playboys, Karina Karina.
Corrine, Corrina, where you been so long? Tell me, Corrina, where you been so long? Ain't had no lovin' since you've been gone. Oh, Corrina. Yes, Leon. Swing out, boy, swing out. I love Corrina. Tell the world I do. I love Corrina. Tell the world I do. Just a little more love and let your heart be true. Heart be true, yeah. Shining bright. Don't let that happen no more, Corrine. Look out, Al. Yeah. I love Corrina. Tell the world I do. I love Corrina. Tell the world I do. Just a little more loving. Let your heart be true, yeah. Goodbye, Corrina. This is farewell. This is very well. When I get back, babe, you never can tell. Oh, nah.
Bob Wills and his Texas Playboys, Karina Karina, a song that's had many lives. In 1956, Big Joe Turner recorded an R&B version for Atlantic Records, and it became one of the first rock and roll hits. Time for an email. This one's from George Blaster from Davenport, Iowa. He writes, Dear Bob, I'm having trouble with my 2-year-old son. He cries, has tantrums, and won't listen to a word I say. What can I do? P.S. Keep on playing them swinging tracks. Well, thank you, George. Sounds like your child's going through the terrible twos, a developmental stage that begins sometime in the toddler years. Your child will grow out of it, but here are some tips to help you get through it. Have a regular routine for meals, naps, and bedtime. Offer limited choices only, such as, would you like apples or oranges for your snack? And not just what do you want for your snack. Learn to set limits. Don't give in to tantrums and begin to use timeouts. Not everybody goes through the terrible twos. Billie Holiday has a song about Mandy. She's 2 and she's doing fine.
is too. You ought to see her eyes of cornflower blue. They really look as if they actually knew that she's a big girl now. Mandy is too. To see how many things she can do. She knows her alphabets and ties her own shoes, and no one showed her how. If you could see Her Majesty Sunday bow came around and brought her an orchid to wear. Mommy is blue because her little girl is going on 3. But Miss Amanda, she's as proud as can be, 'cause she's a big girl now. If you could see Her Majesty with braids in her hair, almost as though her Sunday bow around and brought her an orchid to wear. Mommy is blue because her little girl is going on 3. But Miss Amanda, she's as proud as can be, 'cause she's a big girl now.
That was Billie Holiday. Mandy is 2. The song was written by Johnny Mercer, who had a daughter named Georgia Amanda, who was the inspiration for that song. The name Amanda was created in the 17th century by the playwright Colley Cibber, who based it on the Latin word meaning lovable. She's not that lovable going through the terrible 2s. Next up, here's a traditional song by Ralph Stanley and his brother Carter Stanley. It's called Little Maggie. Maggie is a form of Margaret. St. Margaret was martyred in the 4th century. She is the patron saint of expectant mothers. The song is a close relation to another Southern mountain ballad called Darling Corey, focusing on a hard-drinking, fast-shooting mountain girl defending a moonshine still. Here's Little Maggie.
Over yonder stands Little Maggie with a dram glass in her hand. She's drinking away her trouble and a-courting some other man. Oh, how can I ever stand it to see them two blue eyes shining in the moonlight like two diamonds in the sky. Flowers were made for blooming, pretty stars were made to shine, pretty women were made for loving, little Maggie was made for mine. Last time I saw my little Maggie, she was sitting on the banks of the sea, with a 44 around her, and a banjo on her knee. Thank you. station with my suitcase in my hand. I'm a-going to leave this country. I'm a-going to some far distant land. Go away, little Maggie. Go and do the best you can. I'll get me another woman. You can get you another man.
Little Maggie, recorded in 1946. While we're on the subject of the high lonesome sounds of the Stanley Brothers, here's a story about Pretty Polly by a woman with a beautiful name, Alexandra Aline McLean Denny. But her friends knew her better as Sandy. Here she is, Sandy Denny, doing a murder ballad, Pretty Polly, telling the story of a young woman lured into the forest, where she is killed and buried in a shallow grave.
Polly, Pretty Polly, come go along with me. Polly, Pretty Polly, come go along with me. Before we get married, some pleasure to see. She got up behind him and away they did ride. Got up behind him and away they did ride. Over the hills and the valleys so wide. They rode a little further and what did they spy?
Denny with Pretty Polly. This song was known as a broadside ballad, a commercial art form of the 17th and 18th century. A broadside, or broadsheet, is a large single sheet of paper used to publish advertisements, public notices, political messages, and the like. They are also used to publish songs, often of a lurid, scandalous, or political nature. They're kind of like tabloids that you can glue onto a wall.
I called Betsy again in her office and she said maybe we go to a movie together after she gets off work tomorrow. That's my day off. At first she hesitated, but I called her again and then she agreed. Betsy, Betsy what? I forgot to ask her last name again. Damn, I gotta remember stuff like that.
We started off tonight with Anna. We don't have time to play the entire alphabet. But believe me, there's a girl's name for each and every letter. And if you don't believe me, A is for Abigail, B is for Beth, C is for Carly, D is for Diane, E is for Eve, F is for Francine, G is for Gloria, H is for Hillary, Isabel, Judy, Catherine, Laura, Melissa, Natalie, Olivia, Penelope, Quincy, Rachel, Stacy, Tracy, Ursula, Vivian, Wendy, Xenia, Yvonne, and Zelda. Here's another one with Z. Zindy Lou by The Chimes. A Coco Wicca No and a Coco Wicca Shay.
A Coco Wicca No, a Coco Wicca Shay. A Coco Wicca No, a Coco Wicca Shay. A Coco Wicca No, a Coco Wicca Shay. A Coco Wicca No, a Coco Wicca Shay. A Coco Wicca No, a Coco Wicca Shay.
Zindy Lou was a woman that came from the hills, and a little bright dog as she was with the girls in the loo. She had two great big beautiful eyes, and the Lou was a woman that I idolized. And the Lou, 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 oh, 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 Zindy Lou,
Lou, Lou, Lou, a Zindy Lou, 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 a Zindy Lou. A Coco Wicca No, a Coco Wicca Shay, a Coco Wicca No, a Coco Wicca Shay, a Coco Wicca No, a Coco Wicca Shay, a Coco Wicca No, a Coco Wicca Shay. She had black hair and ruby red lips, and when she smiled at me, I almost offended to Cindy Lou. Ooh, 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 Cindy Lou. When she walked by with a fine frame, each and every man would call her name. Cindy Lou, ooh, Cindy Lou, ooh, Cindy Lou, ooh, Cindy Lou. A Coco Wicca, you know. A Coco Wicca Shay, a Coco Wicca No, 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 a Coco Wicca Shay.
Lou was smiling, she sure was smiling, and when she kissed me, I lose my eyes in the Lou.
Zindy Lou, a woman who came from the hills, who can really thrill a Coco Wicca No and a Coco Wicca Shay. You can always trust a vocal group with a guy named Pookie in it, and the Chimes are no exception. They feature Pookie Wooten, Charlie Jackson, Dave Cobb, and John Talbert. You can also hear them backing up Tony Allen on his R&B classic, Night Owl.
Night Owl.
Our next song was a hit by the Everly Brothers, but we're going to play it by the man who wrote it, Mr. Roy Orbison. The Everly Brothers needed a song for the B-side of their new single, and they asked Roy if he had anything. He sang his new composition, Claudette, and they asked him to write the words down. He did, on top of a shoebox. Here's Roy Orbison with the original demo version of Claudette.
Well, well, hey, hey, yeah, now I got a brand new baby and I feel so good. She loves me even better than I thought she would. I'm on my way to her house and I'm plumb out of breath. When I see her tonight, I'm gonna squeeze it to death. Claudette, pretty little pet Claudette, never make me fret Claudette. She's the sweetest little girl that I ever met. I got the best love that I'll ever get from Claudette. Pretty little pet Claudette. Well, I'm a
lucky man, my baby treats me right. She gonna let me hug and kiss and hold her tight. But when the date is over and I'm at her front door, when she kissed me goodnight, I'll holler more, Claudette. Pretty little pet, Claudette. Never make me fret, Claudette. She's the greatest little... greatest little girl that I ever met. Got the best love that I'll ever get from Claudette. Pretty little bit Claudette. Well, when me and my new baby have a date of three, I'm gonna ask my baby if she'll marry me. I'm gonna be so happy for the rest of my life when my brand new baby is my brand new wife, Claudette. Pretty little pet, Claudette. Never make me fret, Claudette. She's the sweetest little girl that I ever met. Got the best love that I'll ever get from Claudette. Claudette.
Claudette by Roy Orbison, written for his wife, who unfortunately was killed in a motorcycle accident in 1966.
This is Jenny Lewis, and you're listening to Theme Time Radio Hour with your host, Bob Dylan.
Next, we have a song written by a famous guy for another famous guy's daughter, who ended up becoming famous herself. Let me explain. Frank Sinatra had a daughter named Nancy. Frank had a friend named Phil Silvers, who was a very funny comedic actor. You might remember him as Sergeant Bilko on the old TV show.
Looks like a check from a bank.
The National Underwriters Insurance Company in settlement for accident?
5 years ago, I was hit by a cab.
Goodbye.
Phil Silvers heard songwriter Jimmy Van Heusen playing around with a melody, and he said, hey, let me try to write a lyric to that. He wrote Nancy with a Laughing Face in honor of Frank's new daughter. They sent the song to Frank, who was performing in New York. He was choked up and introduced it on his next radio broadcast. Imagine their surprise when Frank was performing and he asked the audience, what do you want to hear? And a large number of the audience yelled back, Nancy with a Laughing Face. It turns out that the song captured the public's imagination, and soon it was number one in the Stars and Stripes hit parade. Let's listen to what they all yelled about.
If I don't see her each day, I miss her. Gee, what a thrill each time I kiss her. Believe me, I've got a case on Nancy with a laughing face. She takes the winter and makes it summer. Summer could take some lessons from her. Picture a tomboy in lace. That's Nancy with a laughing face. Have you ever heard mission bells ringing? Well, she'll give you the very same glow. When she speaks, you would think it was singing. Just hear her say, hello. I swear to goodness, you can't resist her. Sorry for you, she has no sister. No angel could replace Nancy with a laughing face. Betty Grable, L'Amour, and Turner. She makes my heart a charcoal burner. No angel could replace my Nancy with a laughing face.
If I don't see her each day, I miss her. Gee, what a thrill each time I kiss her. Believe me, I've got a case on Nancy with a laughing face. That was Frank Sinatra with a composition by Phil Silvers and Jimmy Van Heusen in honor of Nancy Sinatra. Nancy, of course, went on to have some hits of her own, including Sugartown, Summer Wine, Lightning's Girl, Some Velvet Morning, These Boots Are Made for Walking, and a duet with her father, called Something Stupid.
Let me tell you something about Mona.
Do please.
There's Bo Diddley cracking the Mona Code, a song maybe written about the famous painting, the Mona Diddley. Tell you, Mona, what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna build my house next door to you. Mona, a name that's derived from the Irish, which means little noble one. It appears we got time for just one more. Here's an artist we played on our Christmas show. Gene Ammons was one of the greatest tenor saxophone players that ever lived. And occasionally he had an R&B recorded, like this one, about Sweet Jenny Lou. One of those records that just shows you the thin line between jazz and R&B.
Sweet Jenny Lou.
Jenny Lou.
The time is right.
So right.
Sweet Jenny Lou.
Let's get some Lou.
Too old, too tight.
Yes, the night is right.
Every day that you're away, I always stay by myself.
I'm so lonely without you.
It ain't no fun to be the one on the shelf.
It's bringing me down.
Sweet Jenny Lou.
You know you love me, babe.
This is romance.
Take that move.
So
what say you?
What to do?
Let's take a chance.
Take a chance, take a chance.
Put your arms around my neck. Oh, what the heck, we're alone.
Kiss me now.
And you're my baby. Baby, me sweet Jenny Lou, my own.
Interrupted when he served time in prison between 1958 and 1969 for drug usage. Nowadays, he would have gotten a slap on the wrist and put into rehab. But back then, we were robbed of 10 years of his lyrical, musical voice. Fortunately, he left behind a lot of great records, such as Sweet Jenny Lou. Well, a Cocowicky No and a Cocowicky Shay. We gotta go for another day. But let me leave you with the words of Carl Sandburg. A woman named Tomorrow sits with a hairpin in her teeth and takes her time. And with that, we take our leave. We'll see you next week, right here, on Theme Time Radio Hour. Themes, dreams, and schemes, and things of that nature.